Catwoman, I'm gonna kind of tilt her head. That was my Catwoman tilt, in case you missed it. Slightly different. That's her shoulder socket, center line, chest. It's important to do the chest and then, add the details, but you want the basic structure there. Ear over here. Eyes on that center line. You guys can see that? I'll do it again. I'll do it slower. All right. For Eric. All right. Center line. Hair. Eyebrow. Okay. The eyes sit inside those sockets there. Nose comes off that center line. Lip, chin. So I'm just kind of drawing the half that face, and then the other half is over here, of course. I think you would do anything, whether you're playing the piano or tennis, anything, man. Like, they're able to do things. You watch people that play pool and what they're able to do with shots and make, like, cue ball jump over and the spins they can do. It's amazing. And so, if you just draw for a long period of time, you can do this faster. That's my one trick, I guess. So this is a classic Darwin Cook costume, which is amazing, I think. Of all the costumes we changed, and we changed a lot of venerable, iconic characters, for better or worse, of course, depending on your tastes, when we did the New 52. But the one character that has kind of survived New 52 and Rebirth and all that is the Catwoman costume that Darwin Cook created back, is it the 2000s? I don't know, he did that run with Ed Brubaker. Late 90s, I can't remember. Wow. So I'm like looking at this one. Wow. Her lips look kind of small compared to her eyes and nose. Luckily, I'm able to adjust and kind of beef up those lips, put a little fat in there, fat injections. Kind of beef them up a little bit, make them larger. So even this, because it's in 3/4, perspective, right? We're not looking at it flat on, we're turning it this way. You're going to see more of this side of her lips than the other side. So from the distance of the middle to here, the middle to the end, you can see how it changes. The middle of the lips to the end over here is a lot longer than the middle to that. It's kind of tucked around that corner because the lips protrude out. Chin. Okay, let me go back to the eyes. Make them a little bit more almond-shaped. Tear duct. little bit of arch to our eyebrow there. So I'm drawing both directions, meaning I'm drawing as the pen moves this way, and I'm drawing when the pen moves this way. It's hard to see, I think, if you're looking straight over, but it is faster as you're drawing, because you're not wasting time moving back to your starting point. Loop here. And you can see it's, look, it's not completely consistent. So I put that down and I know that I can go in and adjust the line so slightly. Add a little shadow underneath here. All right. So now it starts looking more refine. Okay, so then this is the center line. That's where sort of the center of those goggles would be. 5 minutes left. There's one goggle. There's the other. Again, just like here, I just kind of approximate shapes. I can fine tune it later. The strap has to come down here. Do double lines here. Gives a little more feeling of being real. And one ear there. The other ear here. And the top part of the head has to be here, right? Seems like, yeah, sell this roundness right here a little bit more. The thing is, I can go fairly loose, sort of carefree in this. It's a, I don't know if it's leather or vinyl or not. It's that material. My mind is sort of not fully engaged here. But I know I'm going to go with a dry brush and kind of finish off the textures. That. But as you, again, as you get, as you do more and more of it, you feel more and more comfortable with drawing the human form. It gets easier every time you draw that same shot. Let's see if I can do this here. Did I screw it up? Perhaps.
No.
It's all good.
Hands of a professional.
It's 12. Almost done. I just basically have to fill in the blacks here with this brush. And then I'm going to go in with some white out, clean it up a little bit. A lot, actually. Sort of give this one away. I think this one turned out kind of nice. Each sketch, even if you've done it 100 times or 1,000 times, they all turn out slightly different. They all have a slightly different personality to them. So even some of these lines I'm doing here with the brush, because her costume is so shiny, it's almost like they're reflections of things around her. If that makes any sense. Go to Amazon and buy it, and that's where I buy it, and that's what I use to pencil with, sort of professionally. And at this point, I didn't like where that center line went, so I'm going to redraw it anyway. The elf woman and the cat woman, yes. Some mascara, eyeshadow. Figured out the difference between the two. First off, I'm going to start cleaning up the stuff that way just out of bounds. And then I'll do like actual drawing with the white out. Right now I'm just kind of fixing things that went way over into areas. So I don't frisk it, I don't mask it off. I mean, you could, I guess. It seems like a lot of extra work, and especially if I know I'm. So even on my originals, like that Batman Hush 15th anniversary cover I did, there's a ton of whiteout on it. I kind of like it. I remember the first time I saw an original, like Bill Sienkiewicz or any of these guys, you would see the whiteout. You would see razor blade marks where they were doing rain and stuff like that. It was just really cool to see the tricks that you can create using pen and ink on board and how that prints and looks like rain or something else entirely different. Okay. And so I like it. I The only person that you don't see white on the boards is like Michael Golden. He would actually pencil and ink around the lines when you could have easily kind of just dropped in a white line using whiteout, and that's the kind of person he is. So technically precise and amazing. Okay. All right. So now I'm gonna do some of the special effects. I'm gonna pull some lines through here to make it actually look like a reflection and not just brush marks. Paper. Some thinner bits of hair. Black and white. Top part of that ear. Some highlights here. The center line. Let's go down here. Not that line that much. It's here more. But it saves me time and effort. Appreciate it. I just kind of clean up the ends of the hair so they're not so blunt. I don't know if this was up here, but kind of fix that. Close some of these gaps up here.
This guy's been stoned since the third grade.